And they were winning as usual. Jehovah was with them, and when he's with you, you can't lose. But mistake number one, what was it? Dang, you were supposed to be doing something. You're supposed to be renewing your mind. You didn't. You were supposed to be apologizing to somebody. You didn't. You were supposed to repent of your sin, and you didn't. Okay, you slacked off on it, and you know what happened to you? You got screwed. Let's take a look at a royal screw job here. When you're not doing your job, the devil catches you, he spots you, and then he takes advantage of you. As soon as you let your guard down, he moves in, just like that. Why? Because he's watching you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, looking for an opening. And since nobody's perfect, everybody gets caught sooner or later. Nobody lives a perfect, totally victorious life, with the exception of one person. Well, that should have landed. David tarried. Mistake number one. He wasn't out supporting his people. He's at home. He's tired. He wants to sleep in his own bed, sleep with his wives, have a great meal. David's getting a little older, getting a little soft. And it happens to all of us. Came to pass at the evening, David arose from the bed and walked up on the roof. I underlined that word because I'm going to need you to remember that word later. Roof of the king's house, and he saw lust of the what? Eyes. He shouldn't have been up on the roof at all. He should have been where he was supposed to be, but now he's up on the roof. He goes up there, he's pooped, wants to relax, catch a breeze. I get it. I would have done it too. And there she is, working a pole right over there. He looks down off the roof, and somebody happens to be there. Oh, really? Happens to be there? I don't think so. He stares. Then, wow. Unfortunately, this woman didn't look like somebody dug her up. Ah, far from it. This chick was dropped. I mean, a 10. I need to stop there.